it's a wonderful time of the year because you get to spend a bit more time at home, not having to go to sleep as early as you would do because of the summer holidays. So I suppose it's a good opportunity to get outside and to actually do some stargazing. Is there anything big that we can look out for between now and maybe September, let's say?
There's actually a couple of really interesting things happening throughout August. One that we'll be able to see throughout the entire month is the planet Jupiter. And that's going to be over towards the southern horizon. If you hold your hand up to the horizon like that, with that on the bottom of the horizon and that at the top, it'll be about that high off the horizon. And it'll be the brightest thing that you see in the sky after the moon. So you'll know if you've seen it. There's also going to be on the 12th of August is the peak of the Perseids meteor shower. So this happens every year at the same time. So the sun's going to set at around about 8:30. So if you can get any time out in the evening after 8:30 and try and see this meteor shower.
We talk about it quite a lot, but I mean, what is the Perseids shower?
A meteor shower happens when Earth passes through the stream of debris that's been left behind by a comet. And when Earth passes through that, those tiny pieces of gravel basically hit the Earth's atmosphere and glow really, really bright white hot. And we see that as a streak of light shooting across the sky.
Can you see these kind of things when it's cloudy and overcast?
I always say if it's partially cloudy, that does mean it's partially clear. As long as you're sitting there and you have a bit of patience, hopefully you'll get to see something, even if it's just through a gap in the clouds. So one of the things that you can see throughout the year is the constellation of Ursa Major, or a bit of it that is more commonly known as the Plough, which you can see back here. So Ursa Major is the Great Bear. I personally struggle to see the bear, but that's what it's called. And so you have a part of it here, which is called the Plough. And that's one of the things that a lot of astronomers use to start helping them navigate their way around the night sky. So that's the one you want to look out for.
So for someone who maybe doesn't know what they're doing, what top tips would you give to be successful at stargazing at night?
First of all, be prepared. Make sure that you stay warm. Even though it is the summer, it can be quite warm during the days, but at night it gets cold very quickly, especially if it's clear. You also want to make sure that you're somewhere safe and somewhere that you're allowed to be. Get away from artificial light. So that's things like street lights, your house lights, your phone. Even if it's just you're standing in that one corner of your garden that isn't directly underneath the streetlight, that will really help. Give your eyes a bit of time to adjust to the darkness. You might have noticed that when you're going to bed at night, when you first turn out the light, you can't see anything. And then after a couple of minutes, you can start seeing, you know, your desk and your pile of clothes on the floor. That's because your eyes get more adapted to the dark as time goes on. For me, the thing that really started my love with space and the night sky was when I was on holiday down in Cornwall. And it was the first time I'd ever really been away from lights and away from light pollution. And I looked up and I saw the Milky Way, which is this incredible band of stars. There's so many, you can't even tell individual stars anymore. They all blend in together. And that was absolutely stunning. And that's always been my favorite memory.